the Apple Vision Pro, an excellent headset that you've probably heard a lot about already if you're in the VR scene. I've been using it to do many things like create videos, watch movies, and other exciting stuff like taxes. If you've seen my content though, then you know I love VR games, especially ones like VR Chat and the like. So it's a shame that this $3,500 headset with hand and eye tracking, bokeh-aided rendering, and 4K micro-OLED displays doesn't support SteamVR gaming. Since this headset doesn't come with controllers or games like VR Chat and Beat Saber, VR gaming just isn't something that you'd be doing on here. And that's actually on purpose since the Vision Pro is meant to be a productivity headset first. There are some immersive games like Jetpack Joyride 2 and Game Room, but no VR ports just yet. So if I want to use my Vision Pro to get my fix of the crazy stuff that people create in VR Chat, or suck at a song in Beat Saber, how could I? Well, a few weeks after the headset's release, we've already gotten confirmation that Virtual Desktop and iVRy, two great ways to stream PCVR games to the Quest, are being worked on for the Vision Pro. Of course, it's up to Apple as to whether they'd allow them on their App Store, but work is being done to bring these VR experiences there. However, you don't need to wait for these developers in order to play SteamVR games on the Vision Pro, as you can see here. This right here is me in VR Chat using the headset to stare at myself, like those weird mirror dwellers. And it is all possible thanks to ALVR, an open source alternative to Virtual Desktop that was ported to the Vision Pro only 3 days after the headset was released. It takes some time to set up and even more time to troubleshoot, but once it's done, I'm here in SteamVR. Since it's still pretty primitive, there are a lot of issues like compression, artifacts, and latency, but other than that, everything runs like a regular VR headset like the Quest. Because of the lack of controller support, I use an Xbox controller to navigate around these games. However, if you have Valve Index controllers and base stations lying around, you can actually use those to turn this into a pretty solid VR headset. In my testing, I wasn't able to get the eye or hand tracking to work, but it'll only be a matter of time until they're supported. It'll be cool to see all the different advancements in this field as time passes, and I'll definitely keep track of them, so subscribe! Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and take care!